Hello, St. Bernard's, and welcome to the 2020 Athletic Banquet. Many things during COVID-19 pandemic have had to be altered, and this year too, our Athletic Banquet, we find ourselves doing it virtually, not at the Riverside Ballroom like we have loved to do for so many years prior. We felt it was, as a board, we felt a strong need to make sure that we honor this year's athletes as well as our eighth graders. So let's begin in prayer with Father Mark.
Hello, Bears. Father Mark here with a prayer for the Athletic Banquet. I look forward to this banquet every year. One, I love seeing all of you receive the recognition and the awards you well deserve by one, being great team players, good athletes, but athletes of faith. But two, I love hearing our speakers, our main speaker, welcome home, but also our student representative speakers, always top notch, and I've grown to really enjoy and appreciate all of you. So I love this. In addition, the piles of chicken bones and the crazy chicken stuffing of that really interesting texture. Always a treat. Let's pray. Lord God, bless our athletes. Fill them with faith. Help them to be for you with each other, a great team that gives honor to your name, but also lifts up the dignity and the talents of each other. Bless them and all our families who call St. Bernard's School home. Almighty God, bless you and all of us, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Go Bears.
Thanks, Father Mark. During the past year, we have had 130 students participate in athletics at St. Bernard's. For some, this is their only opportunity to play. For others, this is their opportunity to be a leader. And for all student athletes, this is your opportunity to build relationships, play with your classmates, and play with pride for St. Bernard's. Traditionally at the Athletic Board Banquet, we honor two students with the Murphy Award, one young woman and one young man who exemplify what it means to be a student athlete. This year, those awards will be given during the farewell mass for eighth graders. Also, we have always had one eighth grader and girl and one eighth grade boy speak to us about their time at St. Bernard's. This year, it gives me great pleasure to introduce Moira Merrill and Austin Bokes.
Hi. My name is Moira Merrill, and in these past 11 years of going to St. Bernard's, my favorite activities were sports. All of these years at St. Bernard's have helped me become closer to so many people, and as my relationships grew, so did my devotion to my favorite sports. I have made so many friends and memories doing athletics. So many people have helped me be the best teammate and player that I can. First of all, God, because He is the one who gave me the love of sports. Second are my friends and teammates because they all inspire me to do the best that I can. Third are my parents and grandparents because they bring me to practices and games and they always support me. Sometimes we even go to Culver's to get ice cream after. Also there are my brothers because they are always helping me get better at all the sports that I do. Next I would like to thank all of my coaches for teaching me how to play and act on a team. They have always believed in me. Sports have impacted my life because I've met some of my closest friends doing sports. They all inspire me. Also, they have taught me how to be respectful, a good sport, and smart. Being respectful to others is important because you want to be nice to people so that they would do the same to you. Like in soccer, if someone gets hurt, you kneel down and you make sure that they're okay. Being a good sport is helpful because you don't want to be seen as a mean person. If you win a game, be nice about it and don't be cocky. If you lose a game, be happy that the other team won. Lastly, I learned to be smart. You have to be smart because you need to know your teammates' strengths and weaknesses. You can't throw a basketball really hard at someone that can't catch a ball that's going really fast. All of these things have made me both a better person and a better teammate. I'm so grateful for all of the opportunities for sports that I was given going to St. Bernard's. Thank you. Go Bears.
Hi, as some of you may know me, I'm Austin Bokes, and I'm an 8th grader at St. Bernard School. I have been playing St. Bernard sports for 6 years. I may have only played one sport, but I am still very proud of how much the programs for all the sports played at St. Bernard's have grown over the years. I am close to all of the other sports because I have friends in all of the other sports. Thank you to all of the parents that would come out every single night if they had to, and cheer us on during the games. I have so many memories at St. Bernard basketball, playing on the court and off the court. watching friends play and cheering them on, while they, in return, would watch and cheer us on. I also remember the first time my mom coached the basketball team. That was a very, very big day. Everything changed when everyone else grew a little bit physically, but I never did. But I still found my way on the team to be a team player and a leader. I have learned so much from St. Bernard Sports, like leadership, respect, self-accountability, and a lot of other personal qualities. I would like to thank all the coaches that have taken their own times to get every other team in St. Bernard's ready to play and be at their top, especially my old basketball coaches, Mrs. Lamb, Mr. Hunter, Mr. Penzenstadler, Mr. Collins, Mr. Metz, Mr. Kipley, Mr. Hyroff, Mrs. Vance, Coach Jake, and finally, Coach Bokes, a.k.a. Mom. Thank you to all of the families and family members who donated to the school so they could get a new scoreboard, new volleyball net, new soccer uniforms, and the gym waxings for the future. I just want to say that everybody that is involved in St. Bernard Sports are so lucky. They are in a great program, and they are in hands of people who care, and we want to thank them a lot. Thank you to all of my past teammates who were always supportive, even if we were down by more than 30 points. We always found a way to stay in the game with our heads held high.
Just a few weeks ago, we were offering up prayers for one of our own St. Bernard graduates who was following his dreams. And today I have the pleasure of welcoming back James Morgan, New York Jets quarterback, to speak to you.
What's up, St. Bernard? My name is James Morgan, and I'm a quarterback for the New York Jets. A couple years back, I was actually in your shoes. I went to St. Bernard for middle school, and I grew up in the Green Bay area. I'm so fortunate to have the opportunity to talk to you tonight. I just wanted to share some things from my journey, and hopefully when you listen, you may be able to take out some things and insights that you can use in your own. In terms of my journey, by no way did it go how I thought it would. There were a lot of bumps in the road. However, I came to realize later on that those bumps and those lows really made me into the person that I am today. If I can leave you with anything from what I say tonight, I hope you remember from this speech to persevere despite whatever struggles you may encounter and never give up on your dream. I had an old coach once tell me, I believed in spite of the evidence and I watched the evidence change. I've really taken that message to heart throughout this journey. Since I was 4 years old to the point that I was at your age to when I was older to now, my entire life my dream has been to play quarterback in the NFL. No quarterback in the Green Bay area had been drafted since the 80s. Statistically, I should not have made it. I decided not to listen to those statistics and forge my own path instead. I went to Ashwaubenon High School after I graduated from St. Bernard and had a great high school career. I actually ranked 5th all-time in Wisconsin high school history for passing yards. However, no big offers came, and especially not from the school that I most wanted to go to, the University of Wisconsin. I just knew that my path would be to go to Wisconsin, start from my home state at quarterback, and then go to the NFL. That wasn't the case. I was left surprised and disappointed because I knew so strongly what I was capable of, and it seemed like nobody else did. I formed a chip on my shoulder and decided to go to the best situation for me, which was Bowling Green State University, a D1 program, albeit a smaller one, in Ohio. My plan was simple. I would go to BG for 4 years, do great, and then go to the NFL. Yet again, it did not happen like I thought it would. After only 1 year at Bowling Green, the coaches I was recruited by left. I worked hard to earn a starting spot as a redshirt freshman, but the new coaches who came in had a different plan for the offense that didn't include me, and I lost the starting spot. Again, I was surprised and disappointed. My NFL dream was so much in jeopardy, and I had to ask myself if football is really something that I wanted to do. During that low period in my life, I relied heavily in my faith and asked God for guidance. I soon came to find out that He had a plan for me. Because I took so many difficult college credit courses in high school, I was able to graduate Bowling Green in 3 years with a pre-law degree. I decided to stick with my childhood dream and transfer to a school in Miami, Florida International University. At FIU, I had fantastic teammates and coaches, and that accumulated in a lot of success for me over the past 2 years. I'm so thankful for that opportunity and the fact that I didn't give up and earned back with a lot of hard work my vision for my future. Thanks to sticking it out instead of giving up when times were tough, My childhood dream was realized a few weeks ago when I was drafted in the fourth round to the New York Jets. For me, now the real work begins. But throughout my journey, no matter how many highs and lows, I never stopped believing in myself, despite what the statistics might have said or what people might have said about me. That's what I want to leave you with tonight. You're never too young to have a dream. Whatever your dream is, believe in it with everything you got, and don't let circumstance bring you down. Keep persevering throughout the struggle, and remember that if you're unusual for how hard you work, that's not a bad thing. To get to places that few people have been, you need to do things that few people do. Your dream is worth it, and don't let anybody tell you that you can't achieve it. Always remember that dream, defy the odds, and believe in yourself. Thank you so much for hearing me talk.
Thank you, James. I couldn't have asked for a better message to share with our athletes during this difficult time. Your dedication and perseverance have paid off. We wish you all the best as you begin your next journey. Once a Bear, always a Bear. We would now like to take a moment and recognize three of our coaches who will be leaving us as they have their youngest student as an eighth grader here at St. Bernard's. First, I'd like to thank Eric Gorder, track coach, for all your years in service to the track team as well as the soccer team over the years. Thank you, John Gorrell, for all your years of service to our soccer team. And finally, a huge thank you to Linda Vance, who has worn many hats in the athletic department. She has been our soccer coach, our soccer coordinator, a basketball coach, and worn countless hats on the athletic board. We appreciate all that you have done for St. Bernard Athletics, and you will be missed. This past year, the athletic board identified a couple different options that we needed to help our athletes continue to strive to do their best. Through the SNAP race fundraiser and two anonymous donations, we were able to fulfill those. This summer, we will be putting up a new scoreboard in the gym. We will be having new soccer uniforms for our students to wear in the fall, and we are in the process of getting a new volleyball net. I want to thank all of you that have participated in the SNAP race fundraiser, and a special thanks to our two donors. We are so blessed with your generosity. And finally, to our athletes, thank you for being part of St. Bernard Athletics. Without you and your desire to play, we would not be here today to recognize you. Please know that we are doing everything we can to get you back on the court, on the field, and on the track next season. We are hopeful that we will be there in the fall. To the parents, thank you for supporting your players. Thank you for bringing them to practice, to games, cheering them on, working concessions, and all the other things to help out the coaches. To our coaches, thank you so much for all that you do to make St. Bernard Athletics what it is. Thank you for your countless time and effort that you are working with the students to make them grow both in a better person as well as a better athlete. To the board, thank you for your dedication, your meetings, our Zoom meetings, and everything we have done to continue to make St. Bernard Athletics program a great program. I couldn't do it without you, and you are so appreciated. And finally, to our eighth graders, this is not how your year was supposed to end. Please know that you are in our prayers. Your resilience will serve you well as you move forward. We wish you all the best as you transition to high school, whether that be on the court, on the track, in the classroom, and all the things you choose to do. To all of our athletes, we have your certificates. They'll be coming home to you at some point this year yet. As well as eighth graders, we have your goodie bags that we would normally get at the banquet ready for you at pickup. Thank you all for sharing this time with us. I want to again thank James Morgan, Austin, and Moira for sharing your time with us. We wish you guys all the best, and go Bears.
For you.